Hello dear students, so let us finish the chapter called plant growth and development under neat botany session, including the last topic, that is plant movements. We have completed all the topics regarding this chapter, that we studied the growth phases of the plants, we studied the hormones responsible for the control and coordination of the growth of the plants, we also studied the various processes shown by the plant body such as vernalization, dormancy, etc., right, photoperiodism, etc. Today, we will talk about the very last topic of the chapter, plant movements. That is movement shown by plant. Let me tell you one thing. The movements shown by the plant are always in response to the stimulus. What is the stimulus? Any changes to which the plants respond. If there is a change in the water level, right? Means if the plant has performed lot of transpiration. During summer season, you can see there that the leaves of the plants get earlier, they show drooping down movement. Because during summer season, due to the extreme sun rays, due to the extreme heat, the rate of transpiration is more. So due to this internal change of the water level, the plant's leaves droops down. So drooping down of the leaves is a type of movement, right? In towards the direction of the sunlight, the plants move and grow. That is also a type of movement. So, the plant movements are always shown in response to the stimulus. Stimulus means any change. One more thing. This stimulus can be internal factor or the stimulus can be external also. That is, changing the water level inside the body is internal stimulus. Are you getting that? And getting the sunlight for the growth and movement, the sunlight is a external stimulus. So, plant shows response to the internal stimulus or to the external stimulus, and in response to that stimulus, they show movements. Okay. The next point is presentation time. See, when you touch a hot vessel, you get a stimulus of heat. To get that stimulus, our body needs a sense, that is a sense organ, skin. In the same way, plants also receive the stimulus. It can be external stimulus or internal stimulus, right? So, time taken by a plant to perceive the stimulus is called presentation time. What is presentation time? Time taken by the plant to perceive the stimulus. To perceive the stimulus means to sense the stimulus. Are you getting that? So, the time taken by the plant to perceive the stimulus. Perceive means to sense. Here it is a water change. Here is it a temperature change. Are you getting that? So, to perceive the stimulus, the time taken by the plant is called presentation time. And the next point is transmission time. Let me give you example. Here is the tip of the plant. Okay. Here is the sunlight. So, tip of the plant will receive the sunlight, will receive the stimulus, and here it will perceive it. So, who have perceived the sense of the stimulus of sunlight? The tip of the plant. When it will perceive it, immediately will it show growth? No. Then it will start producing the hormone auxin. The hormone auxin is produced at the site of perception, but it gets diffused into the another shady site. Are you getting that? Then the part of the plant will grow and then it will bend. So, the time taken for transmission of stimulus from the site of perception to this region where it shows the effect is called transmission time. Means stimulus. Or a better example I'll give you. This is the leaf and this is the bird. Bird means which will bloom into flower. We have studied in the previous video. The stimulus is actually received by the leaves. Leaves then produces the hormone. So this is the site of perception where the stimulus is sensed. Then it is transmitted here to the birds and the birds will bloom into flower. Understood? So what is presentation time? Time taken by a plant body to perceive the stimulus. What is transmission time? time taken to transfer the stimulus from the site of perception to the region where the stimulus show its effect. Okay, so I hope you understood till here. Now, as I said, in response to the stimulus by using the presentation time and transmission time, the plant parts, various plant parts, shows movements. So the movement of the plant parts are of two types: autonomic movements and paratonic movements. Plant movements are of two types: autonomic movements and paratonic movements. What is this? The movement shown in response to internal factor. That means in response to the internal stimulus. मतलब ये जो stimulus है, ये जो factor है वो plant body में ही produce हो रहा है. So in response to the internal factors, when the plant part shows movement, it is called autonomic movement. Auto means self. Self movement है ये, in response to the self stimulus. But what is paratonic movement? The movement shown by the plant part in response to external stimulus like sunlight, water, gravity. We know that shoot grows against the gravity, root grows towards the gravity. So the movement of the stem and the root towards or against the gravity is called paratonic, because it is the external stimulus. Gravity is the external stimulus. Understood? So plant movements are of two types: autonomic movements and paratonic movements on the basis of the stimulus. Now let us study the classification of plant movements. The plant movements are classified into three main types. Let me first write it down so that we can save the time to study it in much detail. So students, as we studied just now, plant movements are of two types: autonomic, that is in response to the internal factor, and paratonic, in response to the external stimuli. But these plant movements are classified into three types, that is movements of locomotion, where the plant shows movement from one place to another place, movement of locomotion. Second, movement of curvature or growth, where the plant shows growth in response to the stimulus. And third, movement of variation due to changes in the surroundings, like diurnal changes, water level changes, touch, etc. Due to variations, due to changes, the movement shown by the plant body are movements of variation. Let us study all three in detail. The first type of movement is movements of locomotion. Again, we know it is of two types, that is autonomic in response to the internal factors and paratonic in response to the external stimuli. They show the movement. Okay, that is locomotion. So here, autonomic movements of locomotion are of three types: ciliary movements. We know wall walks, like this structure is having cilia. So due to the back and forth movement of cilia, it can show locomotion from one place to another place. Yes, you must have studied the plant. Being a plant, it can show locomotion from one place to another place. Okay. Second is amoeboid movement. Due to the pseudopodia, amoeba-like movement, the movements of plasmodia of slime molds takes place from one place to another place, which belongs to the plant kingdom. Okay. Third is cyclosis. It is the movement of the cytoplasm around the vacuole in the cell of the plant body. So cyclosis movement, that is movement of cytoplasm around the vacuole, is of two types: rotational and circulation. Very simple. If it is the plant cell and it is the vacuole, okay, then the cytoplasm, that is the fluid part of the cytoplasm, if moves in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction in a regular manner, either clockwise or anti-clockwise in a regular manner around the vacuole, it is called rotational cyclosis. But what is circulation cyclosis? Here, around the vacuole, the cytoplasm moves in zigzag movement, either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, but in zigzag movement. Then it is called as circulation cyclosis of cytoplasm around the vacuole. Okay. So if you see cilia, plant body mein khud hai wo, internal factor hai. Ya uska pseudopodia, wo internal factor hai. Ya cytoplasm inside the cell, internal factor ki wajah se plant shows these movements. So that is called as autonomic movements of locomotion. Now let us study paratonic movements of locomotion. means due to the response of the external stimulus. So here, phototactic means in response to light, the plant shows movement. For example, Chlamydomonas moves in response to the sunlight from one place to another place. Next is thermotactic movement. The slime molds, the plant parts, they move from one place to another place in response to the heat, that is temperature. Third is chemotactic movement. Movement in response to the chemicals. You can see here, chemicals. For example, antherozooids, which are the male parts of the bryophytes and pteridophytes, move towards the archegonia, that is to the female part. So, movement of the male gametes towards the female part in response to the stimulus of chemicals secreted by archegonia is called chemotactic movement. Understood, students? So, this is the first type of plant movement, the first classification of plant movement, that is movements of locomotion, where the plant or the plant part shows movement from one place to another place in response to internal stimulus or in response to external stimulus. Okay. Let us study the second type, that is movement of curvature. Curvature means bending. Bending, that is in response to movement of growth. They are also of two types, autonomic and paratonic. Let us study that. So, second type of movement of the plant, that is movement of curvature or movement of growth, is of two types again, autonomic movement of growth and paratonic. Simple. Here, the plant part shows growth in response to internal stimulus or external stimulus, and due to the growth, it shows movement. Very simple. You have a potted plant kept in one, just a sapling it is, a baby plant it is. You have kept it in one corner of your gallery. Towards which side it will move and grow? Towards sunlight, because we have seen that when sunlight falls on the plant part, the hormone auxin is produced that causes elongation of the cell and growth of the plant part. Due to the growth, it moves and bends towards the stimulus. Okay. So here, the first type of movements of growth are autonomic movements, that is due to internal stimulus, internal factors, in which the first one is nastic movements. Now, what are nastic movements? Nastic movements hum idhar bhi padhne wale movement of variation mein. Here the nastic movements are the movement of growth in response to autonomic stimulus, that is self-stimulus, internal factor. See, epinasty means growth of the upper part of the petals. Suppose ye hai flower, bud hai, ye upper part of petals hai, ye jitna zyada grow hoga utna heaviness ki wajah se bend down hoga, bend down hoga means flower will open. Are you getting that? Whereas hyponasty is growth of the lower part. Due to the growth of the lower parts, it will grow and close. So opening of flower is epinasty and closing of the petals is hyponasty. Epinasty means growth of upper part, hyponasty means growth of lower part. Now here, is the movement in response to the stimulus? No. Nastic movements are non-directional movements. Means, they don't move towards the direction of stimulus. They move in response to the direction of stimulus, but they don't move towards the direction of stimulus. जैसे यहाँ पे जब हम phototropism बोलेंगे, phototropism और these paratonic movements are directional movements. मतलब जिस direction में stimulus है, उसी direction में movement भी होगा और growth भी. यहाँ पे stimulus की वजह से growth होता है, लेकिन उसी direction में movement नहीं होता. Understood? Okay. So the first type under movement of growth. Autonomic movement may first step, nastic movements, which are non-directional movements. And these movements are mostly shown by bifacial organs of the plant. What are bifacial organs? Leaves, petals and sepals are bifacial organs. Bifacial organs means they can show bending only in one direction. Very simple. Agar ye stem hai, ye leaf hai, it can show bending only towards this direction. Will it show bending towards this direction? No. So, bifacial organs are the organs which can show bending only towards one direction. Agar ye shoot liya, it can bend towards the right also, towards the left also. But not the leaves, they show bending only towards one side. Such organs are bifacial organs. their movements are in response to the stimulus but are not in direction of the stimulus. Okay, that is why they are called as non-directional movements. So nastic movements are of two types, epinasty and hyponasty. Epinasty, example, opening of petals of the flower due to growth of the upper part. Hyponasty is erect poppy bud or closing of the petals of the flower due to growth of the lower part. Okay, next is nutation. Nutation, here it is the growth of the stem apices in zigzag manner. Ye hai stem. कभी ये साइड अपाइस ग्रो हो रहा है, कभी ये साइड, कभी ये साइड. एक्चुअली मैंने उल्टा दिखा, पहले यहां से स्टेम अपाइसिस इज ग्रोन हियर, देन हियर, देन हियर, देन हियर. इज इट ग्रोइंग ओनली ऑन वन साइड, ओनली इन वन डायरेक्शन? नो, इट इज अ ज़िगज़ैग ग्रोथ ऑफ द स्टेम अपाइसिस इन रिस्पॉन्स टू इंटरनल फैक्टर, दैट इज कॉल्ड न्यूटेशन. व्हाट इज सर्कम न्यूटेशन? कॉइलिंग ऑफ स्टेम और टेंड्रिल अराउंड द हार्ड सपोर्ट. टेंडर ना क्लाइंबर्स जैसे प्लांट, सो कॉइलिंग, जैसे कि ये कोई स्टेम है, एक हार्ड सपोर्ट है, उसके अराउंड कॉइलिंग हो रहा है. स्टेम और द टेंडरल्स गेट्स कॉइल्ड अराउंड द हार्ड सपोर्ट, दैट इज कॉल्ड सर्कम्यूटेशन. सो दीज ऑल आर ड्यू टू इंटरनल फैक्टर्स, ड्यू टू इंटरनल स्टिमुलस. नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट द ग्रोथ मूवमेंट इन रिस्पॉन्स टू द एक्सटर्नल स्टिमुलस, दैट इज पैराटॉनिक मूवमेंट. फोटोट्रॉपिज्म, विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज हीलियोट्रॉपिज्म, तुमने डिटेल में पढ़ा होगा. मूवमेंट ऑफ द शूट ऑफ द प्लांट टूवर्ड्स द सनलाइट इज फोटोट्रॉपी. यहाँ पे देखो, ग्रो भी सनलाइट की तरफ ही हो रहा है और मूव भी, मतलब इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द स्टिमुलस इट इज मूविंग एज वेल एज ग्रोइंग. ओके, सो दीज आर पैराटॉनिक मूवमेंट. नास्टिक मूवमेंट्स अगेन ऐसे, दे मूव इन रिस्पॉन्स टू स्टिमुलस बट दे डोंट मूव इन डायरेक्शन ऑफ द स्टिमुलस. हियर दे मूव एज वेल एज शो रिस्पॉन्स इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द स्टिमुलस. सो ग्रोथ ऑफ द शूट इन रिस्पॉन्स टू द सनलाइट. So we say that shoots are positively phototropic, but roots are, do the root grow towards the sunlight or away from the sunlight? Away from the sunlight. So roots are negatively phototropic. Geotropism, roots grow towards gravity. So roots are positively geotropic, but shoot grows against the gravity. So shoot are negatively geotropic. Understood? Hydrotropism, again roots grow towards the source of water. Shoot grows away from the source of water. So positive and negative tropism here we are talking about. Next is thigmotropism, movement in response to the touch. The tendrils of the climbers, when get the touch of the hard stem, they start moving around it, they start growing around it. That is thigmotropism. Next is chemotropism, movement in response to the chemicals. We have studied this, growth of the pollen tube in search of ovule. Okay, next is traumatropism. What is traumatropism? Trauma means injury. Whenever there is any injury to the root apices or to the leaf petiole, they start growing in response to that injury. That is called traumatropism. And the last, aerotropism. Roots are negatively aerotropic, means they grow away from the air, away from the atmosphere. Shoots are positively aerotropic. They grow in the aerial part, in the atmosphere part. Okay? So this is all about second type of plant movement, that is movement of curvature or movement of growth. And we will move on to the very last topic, that is movement of variation. They are also of two types, autonomic and paratonic. Paratonic will be nastic there. Dekho difference, dekho. Movement of growth mein, nastic movements are autonomic. But movement of variation may be nastic movements hai, but they are paratonic. Means, here the nastic movements, that is non-directional movements, are in response to the internal stimulus. But here, there will be nastic movements, that is non-directional movements, in response to the external stimulus. Let us study that. So the last type of plant movement is movement of variation due to sudden changes. Autonomous means due to sudden changes in the rhythmic turgor. Are you getting that? See, turgor pressure means what? The pressure exerted by the cell sap of the vacuoles on the cell wall. That is called turgor pressure. If suddenly that turgor pressure changes, the leaves droop down. If the turgor pressure comes back, it maintains, then the leaf again becomes firm. Right? So is it internal? Change of the turgor pressure is the internal factor. Okay? So this is autonomic due to variation in the turgor pressure, due to changes in the turgor pressure. Now, what are paratonic movements due to variation? First is nyctinasty or sleeping movements. It is due to diurnal changes. Means during daytime, like you can see now, it is experienced best now. It is now during daytime, it's sometimes cloudy, it is sometimes sunny. So due to sudden changes in the light reaching to the plant, the leaves may be firm or droop down. Okay, that is nyctinasty due to diurnal changes, due to changes in the day conditions. Second is photonasty, presence or absence of light. We have studied, we know that some flowers open during daytime and closes their petals at night time. Whereas some flowers open their petals at night time and closes during daytime. Jaise ki Brahma Kamal ka bhi season hai. Wo raat mein hi khilta hai, right? So that is due to the stimulus of or changes in the presence or absence of light. Next is thermonasty. Again, there are some flowers which opens their petal in high temperature and closes their petals in low temperature. For example, tulips. So they need the heat related changes. That is thermonasty. Next is thigmonasty. I'll explain these two together, thigmonasty and chemonasty. Due to changes in the touch or the chemicals. Here I will give you the example of the insectivorous plants like pitcher plant, Drosera, Venus flytrap, right? So, ye jo plant hai, it looks like flower and it looks like the petals of the flower, but it's not a flower. And it has a sensory tentacles on its surface. Whenever any insect comes and sits here, due to the touch of the insects and due to the sense of the chemicals, okay, the leaves immediately closes. Eats the plant to take the proteins and again opens, right? So if you see here is a movement of shut and open, right? Is it due to the stimulus of touch of the insect and the chemicals of the insect? But is the movement in the direction of the stimulus? No. So these are nestic, that is non-directional movements, you can say that. Next is seismonasty. What is seismonasty? In response to the stimulus of touch again, shown by the mimosa plant, touch me not plant, jisko hum lazadu ka jad bolte hai, right? Marathi mein, chui mui plant. Jisko touch kiya, to uske sare leaves droop hote hai and again they open after some time. So due to the response of the touch, rain, electric shock, air, due to all this response of the touch, the drooping down of the leaves is called as seismonasty. So here students, we have completed the chapter under botany neat, plant growth and development. I hope you have understood every part very well. Yeah, jo bhi classification of movements maine padhaya, iska maine ek chart jo banaya hai, directly I will send it to you along with the notes of MCQ. So do study well. Soon we will have a test on this topic. Thank you.